Earlier, I spoke to Steve Jobs' co-founder at Apple, Steve Wozniak. I started by asking him what his first memory of Steve Jobs was.
Oh, my first memory was I had designed a computer and was building it in a garage down the street with a friend, and he said, you have to meet this other guy. He went to our high school, and his name is Steve Jobs, and he understands digital electronics, and he also plays pranks at the high school, which I was famous for. So Steve came over, and we met on the sidewalk, as I remember, and we just started asking each other, what'd you do? What pranks did you do? And I would tell which ones I did, and then he, what'd you do? You know, what have you done with electronics? And he built this, and I've designed all these computers, and we just hit it off. And then we you know, merged into other topics that young people are into.
Were you aware that you were with a genius when you were with him?
Well, I was such a genius in computer design that it just overshadowed any, you know, anything he would do in the technical realm. He was very fast thinking. He had an idea. He wanted to go here. He wanted to go there. He wanted to go there. He was almost driven with a lot of anxiety and hypermotion. And he had, but he had great thoughts and he had great thinking. And when we first started Apple, he would often pose very good questions. Why isn't a company organized this way? Why doesn't a certain person do a certain job rather than another person do it? And he was almost always, you couldn't contradict him. He also had this drive to have a role at first. Eventually it would become like power, control, but a role of just having input into every major department and development in the company.
What will he be remembered for more than any other single thing? A particular product, the whole genre of Apple's products, or simply human genius?
I think he's going to be remembered for the categories of products that he took the world towards, the quality of the products that came out of Apple and his other companies, and also that he was an incredible business leader that built a huge company by basically keeping moving in good, solid, well-managed directions. Operational excellence. So he'll be remembered in so many different ways.
Was he an easy guy to work with?
For me, he always respected me. And even in later years, even if I didn't have a very good answer, he didn't ever treat me like, oh, I was dumb or I didn't know that answer. He was very respectful, very nice and polite to me. So I never hung around enough to see, you know, what some people call, you know, brash behavior or whatever.
Was he a control freak?
The impression I got was that he wanted very much to be in control of the quality of products so that they wouldn't slip from insanely great down to just plain great. And everybody, almost everybody who watched him from the outside and from the inside close to him agrees with that.
Steve Wozniak.
And I don't call it control freak. I mean, so he had to explain. You have to tell people, you know, this is not good enough. You got to go back and do it again. Is that a control freak? I mean, you're the CEO. By definition, you are the control.
Steve Wozniak talking about the insanely great Steve Jobs. Tonight's